Hello friends, this is Deepa Suresh. Welcome back to Deep's Kitchen. Today we are going to see three delicious and quick Indian breakfast recipes that are very healthy and easy to make in just 10 minutes. So we are going to see whole wheat dosa, sweet corn sandwich and poha upma. First we will see how to make poha upma. Poha is also known as rice flakes or pressed rice. To begin, you will need 1 cup of poha and soak it in water for 2 minutes. Don't soak it for more than 2 minutes. In the meanwhile, you may chop up onion, red chilli, green chilli, curry leaf and coriander leaves. After 2 minutes of soaking in water, you may drain the water completely and then you have a soft poha ready to make this upma. Here I have a pan over stove with 1 tablespoon of oil, pinch of asafoetida, half a teaspoon of mustard seeds and a tablespoon of chana dal, 2 red chilli, 2 green chilies and a sprig of curry leaf. Fry them for a while and then add half a cup of chopped onion and quarter teaspoon of turmeric. Mix it well and cook for a while until this onion becomes soft. Now add soaked poha into it. Mix it really well and add required amount of salt, a little turmeric to get that nice yellowish color. Give a mix one more time and finally finish it off with some roasted peanut, cashews, coriander leaves and a few drops of lemon juice. And that's all guys, you have poha upma ready to enjoy. So you may serve it with your favorite chutney, especially with coconut chutney, it goes really well. And breakfast number 2 is veg sandwich or a sweet corn sandwich with a lot of cheese. For that, into a bowl take half a cup of boiled sweet corn with 1 tablespoon of red bell pepper, 1 tablespoon of green bell pepper, 1 tablespoon of chopped onion and half a cup of mozzarella cheese. Mix it well. We will add other spices. Before that, add a very little amount of salt and 1/8 teaspoon of ground pepper, 1/8 teaspoon of Italian herb and 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala. I'm going to add garlic and onion spice blend that also has some coriander cumin powder with onion and garlic powder. So if you have, you can use it, otherwise you may skip it off. So I'm just adding only like a teaspoon. Mix it well and here I have 2 bread slices. Apply butter on both sides of each bread. For healthier option, you could use whole wheat bread or oats bread. I'm using a oats bread. So now take your sandwich maker. I am using a grill plate in my sandwich maker and apply butter on each plate. Place your bread slices and spoon in the mixture, that is the stuffing we made with onion and sweet corn, and place another bread on top and cover it. Add it to toast until they become golden in color. So now we have sweet corn sandwich ready and you may cut it diagonally and serve this crispy sandwich with your favorite ketchup or sauce or with any homemade chutneys. Next is breakfast number 3. We are going to make a whole wheat dosa that doesn't need any grinding or fermentation. To begin, into a bowl add half a cup of whole wheat flour, 2 tablespoons of rice flour, 1 tablespoon of suji, finally salt to taste. Add 1 cup of water. Mix it well to make a lump-free batter. I highly recommend you guys to use a whisk so that you will not get any lumps at all. Now you can see the batter is thick. To add another half cup of water. Basically you want this batter to be really thin.
like a buttermilk. You can see the batter is very thin. So for half cup of whole wheat flour, I used 1.5 cup of water. Just check for the salt, and if it is okay, then the batter is ready to make whole wheat dosa. But if you want to add upon some flavor to it, you can add some spices. So I have here some cumin seeds. Just crush it up with your palm. Crushed pepper. I have 1 green chili and few curry leaves, which are very finely chopped. Mix everything well. So just cover it with the lid and let it to rest for 10 minutes. So it's been around 10 minutes I have rested this batter. So now make sure you're mixing up every time you are pouring the batter, because this suji and rice flour, even the whole wheat flour, will settle at the bottom. So now the batter is ready to make our whole wheat dosa. So here I have a tawa over stove and it's really hot. So just sprinkle in some water to check how hot the tawa is. So as I mentioned earlier, make sure you're mixing up really well every time you're pouring a batter. And pour it over. Now add some oil on the top. So you have to wait until the bottom become golden brown, and then you may separate it from the tawa using a spatula, and then we will flip it over. You can see the other side also cooked well with a nice golden color. Now the dosa is ready to serve.
We have whole wheat dosa ready. It is perfect to serve with any of your favorite chutneys. If you are interested, please check out my 5 quick and easy Indian chutneys. The link is in the description. If you want to enjoy more quick and easy breakfast recipes, please thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, remember to subscribe. Thank you so much for tuning in. Catch you guys soon with another great video. Bye bye.